Hello everyone, this is Dr. Jyoti KB, Assistant Professor, Government First Grade College, Kuppi. In today's session, we are going to have a brief introduction to the novel Wuthering Heights written by Emily Bronte. Now in this session, we will have a brief outline of what are the main themes of this novel, what are the elements of plot in this novel, what is the thread of the plot, who are the important characters, what is the setting of the novel, what is the perspective, different approaches to Wuthering Heights in brief. So all these things will be told in a nutshell in this session, and the coming session will talk in detail about these elements which I just now listed out. Now to begin with, this is session 47, Wuthering Heights introduction. So you are supposed to know the socio-historical background of the origin of the novel Wuthering Heights. Students should know the storyline of the novel Wuthering Heights. Students should know the main characters of the novel Wuthering Heights. So these are the things which you have to learn after reading the novel. So you have to know the context. What was the response of Victorian readers to this novel? In two or three sentences, describe Emily Bronte's life. Describe Gothic tradition of the late 18th century or early 19th century. So this is a novel which has come in 19th century. And who are the main characters, major characters of this novel, and who is the heroine of this novel? You have to know something about the theme, the motifs and symbols in the novel. You should know something about the social class which is described in the novel. You should also know the culture which is represented in this novel, and what are the major conflicts, what are the major parallels which are shown in this novel. So before studying any novel, these kind of questions should be answered. Then you are supposed to read everything in detail. Now Wuthering Heights, the facing sheet, the title page shows the house of the main characters which is described in the novel. Now the lines which are shown to you on the screen are the important lines often quoted about this novel. So this is said by the heroine to her lover. So heroine Catherine says these lines to her lover Heathcliff. So these are her feelings towards him. Whatever our souls are made up of, his and mine are the same. So whatever might be our differences, but we are the same. So this is often quoted quote of this novel and very popular saying. It is written by Emily Bronte. Emily Bronte was born in Thornstone in Yorkshire, England on August 20th, 1880. Emily's education was provided at home by her father, so she did not go to a formal school, and her father treated all children, whether it is a son or a daughter, equally and treated them as equal thoughts. She is a very popular novelist and poet, best known for her novel Wuthering Heights. Born in the village of Thornstone as the fifth or sixth child. Mother died when Emily was 3 years old. Two elder sisters died in childhood due to a typhoid pandemic which spread through their school. Wuthering Heights was published for the first time in year 1847. When the book was first released, it was assumed to be written by a man due to the fact that the name of the author was Ellis Bell. So Emily Bronte did not reveal her name in the publication of the novel, she gave a man's name instead of hers. Wuthering Heights is a Gothic romance novel, so it contains Gothic elements, it contains romantic elements. It is narrated by two people, Nellie Dane and Mr. Lockwood. Because of the fact this book has two narrators, it is written in present tense and past tense. So you can find both tenses in this narration. So usually narratives are in past tense. This is a unique kind of narration where there are two narrators, one in describing in past tense, another describing in present tense. Now, there are two generations of people which are narrated in this novel. The first generation is the Heathcliff, Hindley, Mr. Earnshaw and Cathy Earnshaw. So these are the important characters, and the Lintons and their two children, one boy and girl, and the boy is Edgar, Isabel is the girl. So this is the first generation. Then there is the narration of the second generation as the novel proceeds. So we have the short summary of Wuthering Heights given here. So we should know the plot. Plot is the thread of the story, the important key happenings, key actions of the story are called the plot. So it is the thread which creates interest in the readers, and it evokes surprise and amazement at the action. So the line of actions, the thread of actions is called plot. So plot, what happens in the plot? Heathcliff is adopted by Mr. Earnshaw, the owner of the Wuthering Heights. So when the story begins, Wuthering Heights is owned by Mr. Earnshaw, and Earnshaw brings an orphan boy to his settlement to bring him up. So just out of interest, he brings an orphan boy to bring up, and his name is called Heathcliff. And Heathcliff is quite dark compared to his own son, who is Hindley, and his own daughter Catherine. Heathcliff and Catherine are raised together and start to fall in love with each other. So as they grow up, Heathcliff and Catherine fall in love. After the death of Mr. Earnshaw, Heathcliff leaves Wuthering Heights in order to start working to earn money. So after the death of his father, Hindley the son hates and dislikes Heathcliff. So Heathcliff leaves the Earnshaw settlement to find his own independent life, to earn more money than the Earnshaws, so that he can seek Catherine as his wife. So he leaves the settlement, the Earnshaw settlement, to work on his own to earn money. In the meantime, Catherine marries Edgar Linton in order to be introduced in the world of materialism, despite her love for love for Heathcliff. So as Heathcliff is absent in that place, and as the social norms of the Victorian society, a girl chose to marry a man who was richer than the one who is poor. So she was more about worried, a Victorian lady was more worried about how she settles herself rather than the feelings of love, passion, romance, etc. So she gets married to Edgar Linton. So Earnshaw's is one household which is placed in a place called Wuthering Heights, and there is a grange, Thrushcross Grange, which is owned by the Lintons. So they are also rich landlords. So Catherine decides to marry the son of the Lintons, Edgar. So they get married when Heathcliff is not present in the Wuthering Heights. Wuthering Heights is a place. After an absence of 3 years, Heathcliff returns with the desire of destroying Hindley and Edgar, blaming them on losing Catherine. So Heathcliff goes outside and he earns lot of money. Now his only aim is to possess Catherine, who he loved long back. And he starts developing a revengeful attitude on Hindley and Edgar because they took away Catherine from his hands, and the social norms, the materialist things became more important than real love. So he wants to take revenge on Hindley and Edgar, so he comes back. Then he finds that Catherine is already married. Heathcliff, he has grown rich. Now he marries Isabel Linton in order to inherit the Thrushcross Grange, and later they have a son named Linton, born in London. So now he has an intention of acquiring to possess the property of the Lintons, that is Thrushcross Grange, and they have their own son, Linton. Catherine becomes ill and dies after giving birth to her daughter Catherine. So her daughter is also named after her mother. She dies. And Hindley also dies, and the Earnshaw estate and Hareton fall into the hands of Heathcliff. Now, Hareton is Hindley's son. Now, after some days, after Catherine's death, her brother Hindley, who was in Wuthering Heights, he also passes away. And Edgar also passes away. So his son, Hindley's son, called Hareton, is alive. And now Heathcliff comes to Wuthering Heights to take charge of the property. So no one elderly is there. So he is the most eldest. So he takes charge or takes control of the whole property. Now he forces his son Linton to marry young Catherine. So Catherine is the daughter of Edgar, of the son of Linton's family. So Heathcliff has the intention of possessing Thrushcross Grange also. So he forces his son Linton to fall in love or to tempt Catherine to marry him. So Heathcliff's intention is worked out through his son Linton. Both Linton and Edgar die, but his ideas do not work out, or his plans will not succeed, because Linton and Edgar both die. Both Heathcliff's son Linton and Edgar die, and the Grange grows to Heathcliff, who now owns both Wuthering Heights and Thrushcross Grange. So now Heathcliff is the most eldest of all the people of the both places, both settlements. So Heathcliff becomes the owner. After the death of Heathcliff, now after some time, Heathcliff also dies, and the people who are remaining out of both the families is Catherine and Hareton, who is Hindley's son. So both of them fall in love and they get married, and they become the owner of both places, Thrushcross Grange as well as Wuthering Heights. So this is the end of the story. So this is in brief the plot line and the structure. Wuthering Heights is told in media res, that is in the big, this story begins in the middle of the plot. So plots is something chronological which we can understand, but the novel begins in the middle as it reveals. It usually describes a narrative that begins not at the beginning of a story, but somewhere in the middle, usually at some crucial point in the action. The purpose of Wuthering Heights is to add a sense of mystery, suspense, and foreshadowing. So why this technique, why this structure is followed, is to evoke mystery, suspense, and foreshadowing. Now the setting. So where is the novel set? It is in a place called Wuthering Heights. It's a desolate place. Desolate is lonely place on top of a hill. And there is one more place, Thrushcross Grange, a place within the valley that was protected. And the Yorkshire Moors, which is empty and harsh. See the picture of the Wuthering Heights Earnshaw household. So the household where the story happens is shown on the screen. And themes. What are the themes which are dealt in this novel? That is foreignness. Foreignness is somebody who is not the native, who is not the inheritor of the property, is brought from outside and he is brought up. So foreignness, the other, somebody who is dark, who is short, who is stout, is brought from outside into the settlement and he is allowed to grow there. So here we have Heathcliff, who is coming into Wuthering Heights and start growing. And there is a theme of family. So different kinds of families are described. And there is the theme of love between Catherine and Heathcliff, love between the Lintons and Catherine. So Linton, so different kinds of love are dealt, and there is both suffering of physical and mental. So there are different kinds of suffering which are dealt in this novel. Important characters of Wuthering Heights, you have Francis Earnshaw, Hindley Earnshaw, Catherine Earnshaw, Heathcliff, Edgar Linton, Isabella Linton, Nellie Dean is the narrator, and then Herton Earnshaw, Catherine Linton, Linton Earnshaw, and Lockwood. Lockwood and Nellie Dean both are narrators, the people who narrate the story. Okay. Then there are different ways of reading Wuthering Heights. One such is the domestic reading. In terms of its genre, the novel can be seen as tracing a gradual progression away from the Gothic mode of first generation story towards the form of realistic domestic fiction that came to dominate the Victorian novel. The first generation story is characterized by domestic violence, a forced marriage, and incarceration, whereas the second generation story ends with the withdrawal of the hero and heroine into a nuclear family and a gentler home world of Thrushcross Grange. Thus, to some extent, the novel indicates both changing patterns of fiction and the emergence of new forms of story. So this is in brief the plot, the storyline, the main characters, the themes which are dealt in the novel Wuthering Heights. In the coming session, you are studying everything in detail. The plot in detail, the themes in detail, the setting in detail, the narrative technique in detail. Everything will be dealt in detail in the coming sessions.